Hi, I'm Logesh.
Hi, I'm Ricardo.
Hi, I'm Abbas.
Apple was founded by Steve Jobs, Steve Wozniak, and Ronald Wayne in April 1976 to develop and sell Wozniak's Apple I personal computer. Apple now is one of the top American multinational technology companies headquartered in Cupertino, California, that designs, develops, and sells computer electronics, computer software, and online services. Apple has 506 retail stores on 5 continents. It is considered one of the big 5 companies in the US IT industry, along with Amazon, Google, Microsoft, and Facebook. Its hardware products include the iPhone, smartphones, tablets, iMac, and smartwatch. Its online services include the iTunes Store, the iOS Apple Store, Mac App Store, Apple Arcade, Apple Music, Apple TV Plus, Apple Fitness Plus, iMessage, and iCloud. Other services include Apple Store, Genius Bar, Apple Care, Apple Pay Cash, and Apple Card. Brand architecture. Apple logo is presented on all products, which reflects that Apple architecture is a monolithic single master brand where the sub-brands such iPhone, iMac, iPad are marketed under the umbrella of Apple. This helps the corporate to be efficient in the marketing strategy, avoided confusion and competition among some sub-brands, which led to the higher success by reaching the right audience. Since launching, Apple has a healthy marketing and healthy growth. The main reason that Apple kept under the one umbrella name is that it does not have any pitfalls since it started and being big in the eyes of consumers. Apple branded house is one of the biggest strengths as it increases brand awareness globally and made Apple stronger since it is established.
Brand personality. The Apple brand personality is also about simplicity and the removal of complexity from people's life, people-driven product design, and about being a really humanistic company with a heartfelt connection with its customers. Through these qualities, Apple is positioned as being extremely helpful to the people and businesses as they strive to achieve their goals. For Apple, its brand personality is involved into simplicity, high quality, and friendly. Apple has a branding strategy that focuses on the emotions. The starting point is how an Apple product experience makes you feel. The Apple brand personality is about lifestyle, imagination, liberty regained, innovation, passion, hopes, dreams and aspirations, and power to the people through technology. It is necessary for Apple to have this kind of personality to be more unique and be more competitive in the business market, as well as being simpler with all the features it has inside that make it interesting, and it gives independence to the people through technology, made them more private in their duties. As Apple products such as iMac is the main computer, it's utilized in most architectural and field production companies.
Core values. Apple has few core values. However, the most core value is product quality. From launching the first computer to recent release of sub-brands, all the products are known for their reliability, durability, flexibility, regularly breakdown, good online and offline customer service, full technical support. This constitutes the heart of Apple culture and added value to the product, where consumers are willing to pay to eliminate the risk of future performance failure. This alone has shaped the relationship between Apple and consumers and built long-term relationship. The second core value is Apple's statement that we are on the face of the earth to make great products that will change the world. This fully aligned with what Steve Jobs has done, as he prepared product for consumers before they know what they want. This opens the gate for the rest of telecommunication companies such as Samsung, Nokia, Huawei to develop their product and services further and advance in technology that change the lives of whole population. iPhone was the first iPhone that has FaceTime that attracted the consumers to purchase it to facilitate communication among them. This again opens the gate for the development of new apps such as WhatsApp and Viber. Another core value is that Apple participate only in market where they can make a significant contribution and can add value to their product, as the sub-brands are limited and there's a time frame between launching sub-brands. This is very important for consumers.
Brand image. Apple has a brand image which is natural and simpler. Every time you go to an Apple store, there will be a professional staff to solve your issues out, and they will help you with advices on how to look after your mobiles properly. When you are inside the store, you feel valuable and unique by the way they address your issues, and that's how Apple works on building customer relationship management by creating trust and making you proud of being part of the Apple family. I remember when I went to the Apple store with my friend and he was struggling with an featuring inside a mobile phone, and they were so kind and professional, and they make you valuable, and they trust in us, and they solve our issues so quickly and natural. And that's Apple. So Apple is segmented themselves as a product and market oriented that builds up their brand image to huge profits. Continuous new innovation over the year is the best example, and the quality, obviously. So in 2020, Apple became the first US company to reach a market capitalization of over $2 trillion. It means Apple's market value is now higher than the gross domestic product of numerous developed countries.
Reputational elements. From Apple's slogan saying different, this is an indication that Apple produces the best product in the market. Apple products are made in California and assembled in China. This alone has a psychological effect on consumer attitude and reception perception. As the origin of the product is very important, this makes the brand strong among other products, which in parallel allows the consumers to have a very easy decision and does not waste their time in product selection. Apple work hard to achieve consumer satisfaction among competitors such as Samsung, Huawei, and Nokia. Apple is not just a name or logo. Apple brand came up with a lot of combinations that differentiated itself in the market among competitors. According to Forbes, Apple was the award winner of the CMO survey in 2017 for the 10th consecutive years. It has been observed that people buy Apple product because of their affinity to the brand. Apple has achieved a distinctive value, as it has achieved the most successful valuable brand, where customers are willing to pay any price just because they know very well that Apple does not compromise on quality, which is the heart of Apple, and this is the most important part of the brand, where customers feel attached to the product. Apple brand is valued at £241.2 billion in 2020, with an increase of 17% in the previous year. The stock price of Apple is 3 times the price 3 years ago, which is a reflection of consumer satisfaction with the product, loyalty to the brand, and repeat purchasing. However, other competitors have a slight increase in shares. This gives an indication how Apple advanced in technology, innovation, and product development, where they spend a substantial proportion in research and development to satisfy consumers' needs and their expectations.
Strategic mission is to bring the best user experience to its customers through its innovative hardware, software, and services. This reflects the corporate short-term and long-term objectives. Since the corporate it is established, the business mission and vision are achieved, as the product and services that provided to the market are innovative and the best. This leads Apple to be the leader in technology invention. This also reflects how Apple is a dynamic corporate, as it can adapt and readjust with the world changes, where Apple recently involved in new service of Apple Pay service. From my perspective, the success and being the top corporate is that Apple hired different people from different educational backgrounds and from different disciplines, which make Apple to have different product and quality strategic mission.
Brand identity prison. What is it basically? It is a concept for describing a brand's identity through its core characteristic. If you see Apple, these are the core identities: physique, personality, culture, self-image, reflections, and relationship. Let's see a few of the identities here with some examples. Physique, it's focused on design. We can say it's classy, it's simple. And then we've got personality, which is teenage and new generation. For example, we can have an example here about personality, because they are reducing the size of the phone and cutting the accessories for the packagings. That's, they are becoming low carbon and they want sustainability for going carbon neutral. And we can mention as well Apple logo, which is the corporate font Apple uses a modified version of the Myriad font called Myriad Set in Apple marketing materials. Apple name, Rod Janoff, who is the famous logos creator, said that the bite was intended to show the size of the apple, to make it clear it was an apple and not a cherry or some other fruit. Apple color. Apple has a single combination of black and white in its brand color palette.
The bond between Apple and its customer has been very strong over the years in terms of being trustworthy, being loyal, quality customer engaging service, and being reliable. In terms of identifying its target customers, yes, Apple has done it really well. As you can see from the above graph, the percentage of men using the Apple products in all age groups is far more than the women. Also, you can see there's a peak sales of Apple products between the 35-year-old to 55-year-old males. So we can clearly identify that working men are the real targets for Apple.
Hey Siri, you're the best.
Thanks.
So basically, in this section, we will see what emotions does customer have for the brand and what makes them to choose Apple. The first reason is because of its uniqueness. Apple's ecosystem is key to its success. The iTunes, App Store, iOS, macOS, Apple TV, Siri, and Home all tie together. Apple also makes sure they invest a lot of money in research and development and make some new innovations every time so that it makes lives easy. So next is the consumer performer. Here I was just speaking to two of my friends who are Apple users, and I was just asking them what are their goals to buy a phone and what are the motivations to be an Apple user, and what are the factors which is making them frustrated being an Apple user. So their comments was interesting, and have a look at them. Apple's use of social media is very different from most other brands. It does not use social media just for marketing or promotions or only customer service. However, it uses other social media platforms like Instagram and Twitter for effective customer engagement really well. Let's see about the customer-based brand equity model of Apple. Apple has a brand loyalty that most companies can only dream of. Apple isn't the first company to release a product, but it can certainly lay claim to being the first company to release a successful version of that product. If you see the customer engagement model really closely, Apple are really good at designing an environment and an active channel for the customers to share their experience after buying the product, and they also want the customer service problem should be minimized with tight quality control, and they also view this customer management as a long-term investment. Brand associations. The Apple brand is openly loved, maybe even adored, with strong levels of association to words like cool, awesome, and even love. Plenty of brand wants to be loved, but very few can lay claim to that level of strongest or positive association. The words design, creative, innovation are also strongly associated with the Apple brand. It is easy to see why Apple commands such high levels of brand loyalty and continues to create enormous anticipation for each new product launch. They also have partnership with Deloitte, IBM, and Accenture in order to improve their Apple hardware, software, and services. Let's see about some of the Apple's branding campaigns. This was a very promising ad from Apple regarding climate change, where they had a newborn baby sleeping in the bed, and it was something like an Apple spirit was coming and saying in the baby's ears that now we're gonna be carbon neutral by 2030, and now you'll be having a fresh air to breathe, something like that. It was very interesting, and this ad reached millions of people, and this is when Apple is so creative, like in their campaigns, and this was such a promising ad. And the second one is about the privacy campaign. This was a really funny ad from Apple, but again, yes, it was a promising one, where they had a lot of people speaking about their personal information, text messages and email IDs, and they said their credit card numbers. But what Apple wants to say them was iPhone is designed in a manner that it protects your data privacy and have control over everything. So it was really nice ad. So it is an excellent branding strategy, which is carried out by Apple, I would say, because this is something, you know, which increases trust in the consumer and so that they stay loyal, and in the long term, it will be a huge success. So next is the critical discussion and evaluation. So let's see how Apple carries with the relationship marketing strategy. Apple support. Apple really uses this Apple support way of reaching customers effectively and have an effective communication and build relationship. Apple support, you know, just gives you the personalized access to solution for all your Apple products and services. And so that if a consumer is having a problem with a device or wants to know about something or have any repair works or know about some billing, they can reach the online customer service anytime. This is something very unique and very different from other brand. They're just trying to gain the people's trust towards the product. So this is something very interesting and should be appreciated. There is something called Apple Store also, like consumers can able to purchase the Apple products from the Apple Store directly. Apple makes sure they are socially responsible, not just in sustainability, but also supporting some social cause. The recent Watch series was about the proud black history and culture, and this was something very nice to see, and this gained a lot of attention all around the world. Apple also faced some severe backlash when they decided to take the earphone and charger out of the box, like out of the packaging box with the iPhone. This caused a severe upset with the people all around the world, and this was something which was not appreciated by the people. And Apple also was worried, like when the Twitter starts roasting them in a funny way, and even the competitors was roasting them. So Apple's explanation to this issue was not up to the mark, and people were still disappointed. This is a very classic example, like, you know, it tells you like how important you have to build your relationship with the customers. Creating effective and real brand stories. This is something very important for any brand to succeed in a global market. More than creating a brand story, a successful brand makes sure they have an effective narration of the story as well, because it is something that positions them as unique and creates an emotional connection with the customers. I always believe good storytelling is all about and having an emotional connection, because that is what which tunes the people's emotion from inside and builds the trust towards the product or service of the brand. A brand story, you know, it tells the motivation for what you need to buy the product, why you need to choose the product, why you need to choose the brand, why the customer should care, and why they need to trust you. So yeah, Apple has done it really well over the years, and their consumer numbers data is the, you know, proof of that.
If we take the case of Apple Pay, we've got positive and negative to discuss. On the positive side, we can mention it is safe, secure, private, and easy. An Apple user feels so proud and comfortable using it. On the other side, they also have got frustration because they've got Apple and they can go for a shot to buy something, but they cannot pay with Apple Pay because they are not in the whole area. This is a problem because they are lacking with internet connections in some regions, and they are not enough shops having this payment. If you ask for my recommendation, I could say Apple Pay should be modified to be utilized in the application for advert in parallel for small local mobile businesses as part of support, where clients can look at the small businesses services within 1 mile radius. This will encourage small businesses in parallel to have Apple Pay application on their phone or iPad, allow their customers to pay swiftly and easily.